Ian.
Skyliner.
We're on the Skyliner. Are we going to Epcot?
Yeah.
We are on our way to catch another Disney on Broadway concert series. That is literally probably all we're doing today. We might stay for Harmonious. We will see. It is really nice out tonight.
Mm-hmm.
But today
meanwhile, there's a winter storm going on. And
I know. Yeah, Joe is actually supposed to go up to his family's up north and get the car that we're acquiring from his grandmother this weekend. But he rescheduled it when he saw that the snow was coming. And if we wouldn't have rescheduled it, his flight would have actually been canceled with all the snow. So, but instead we're in Florida where it was 80 something degrees.
85
degrees today.
Costume that made me look like a bowling ball. No. A French bowling ball with sleds. Les poissons, how I love les poissons. Love to chop, les douceurs, les deux fish. If it's that cut off the heads, then I pull out the bones. I mean, oui, ça c'est toujours delicious. Les poissons, les poissons. Ha ha ha. With a cleaver, I hack them in two. I pull out what's inside and I share the fight. Oh God, I love little fishes, don't you? Is something for tempting the palate. Prepared in the classic technique. First to pound off your blood with a palate. Then you slash to the skin. It gives a belly a slice.
Chef, hey, it's a family show. Don't scare the children.
The cost of me exceeds a taste nice. Sit hello. I have missed one. Sacre bleu. What is this? How on earth could I miss such a sweet little succulent crab? A kid homage? What a loss. You belong in this sauce. With some flour, I seem just a dab. Then I'll stuff you with bread. The old hack, you'll be dead. And you'll surely be lucky you are. Cause it's gonna be hot in my big copper pot. To die in mon poisson. Au revoir! Isn't it great fun being the bad guy in a Disney movie? We all know The Little Mermaid, right?
Mm-hmm.
We all know that fun story. Can't we all agree here tonight that really Chef Louis is the primary villain in that story? His evil backstory and sort of, you know, thinking about his relationship to the fish and various other sea creatures.
Sit down.
Robert, I'm in trouble. We'll get him for a swap.
I admit that in the past I've been nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me a witch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways, repented, seen the light, and made a switch. True, yes. And I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And here lately, please don't laugh, I use it on behalf of all the miserable, lonely, and depressed.
Okay. wish comes true. The tip is the tap into something that you believe. With a zinc and a zonk and a zizz, I see there ain't nothing you can be. You see, it's really your prerogative. You simply can't think noggin'. And as you just sitting there, smack down flat upon your derriere. Well, if that's the way you wanna be, well, you might as well be shrubbery. So stand right up and dust your seat and walk real tall upon your own 2 feet. And sure, you'll trip and make mistakes, but you got what it takes. Howdy ho, my mind, I gotta dance.
Wesselton in Frozen on Broadway. But I don't know if y'all realize that you are being entertained this evening by the reigning Disney on Broadway king. My friend, Robert Creighton, has been involved one way or another in nearly every single Disney on Broadway show. It's true.
That was so kind of you, my friend, to say that. Actually, she speaks the truth, and I have to just say here, well, Disney World, I feel so fortunate and consciously great.
Okay, Miss America, put your shoes on. I'm just kidding. I love you. Okay, so we've got Little Mermaid, we've got Frozen. Our opening number, if you can rewind and remember what that was, that may be a clue to another role that Bobby played.
So, where are you from?
Any guesses? Go, go, go.
Alrighty, what do we have here? Jesus, a lion, run, Pumbaa, move it!
Bobby played Timon!
Puppet head.
Was that super fun to
super fun.
Learn the puppet?
Yes, amazing.
Have you ever done anything like that before or since that?
Nope.
That's the amazing thing about being an actor. Is
such
you,
an opportunity.
Adventures all the time.
All the time.
Okay, so after Lion King, I know you were involved in the early stages of Newsies.
Yes, Newsies with Alan Menken and the crew team. As they were creating the show from the movie to the stage, I got to do several readings and workshops.
Amazing. And what about Aladdin?
Or Aladdin. Again, with Alan Menken. I found that happens here and it excites me. Alan Menken!
He's our rock star. He's where Broadway and Disney meet. And
genius.
I am a card-carrying member of that dorky club. I love that.
So anyway, with Aladdin, I got to, in the workshop, the first big workshop, I got to play, believe it or not, the genie.
Of course you did. That's amazing. I bet you were fantastic.
I loved it.
What about Mary Poppins?
Oh, such a beautiful show.
We love that show.
Burt in a big, glorious production in California.
You were fantastic.
Thank you.
You're perfect.
Oh, I'm stepping.
There you go. We can do a whole other show. Everybody sit back and relax. We're doing a Mary Poppins.
Really? Okay.
We're going to let Ashley Brown, who was the original Mary Poppins.
Oh, she's coming up.
She's going to knock your socks off. Okay, so let me see, where are we? I know you also, there's so many.
That's
I lost count. Literally.
I mean, I was so lucky I got to do a couple Disney feature films.
Yes, tell them about that.
I got to sing as one of the thugs in Tangled.
That's my favorite.
I had a dream for and then in the recent Beauty and the Beast, the live action sang on that. Been so fortunate.
Yeah, it's amazing. So this resume goes on and on and that's just the tip of the iceberg. But I think I've got you stumped.
Oh,
I do not think you were part of Disney on Broadway's Aida.
Actually.
What? Really?
No, I wasn't in Aida.
You're very funny and talented.
Well, that's why I'm the reigning Disney on Broadway king. Enough of that.
Enough
of him. To your Disney roles.
Back to me.
Yeah, absolutely. That's where we want to be. Now, I'm asking you this. How cool must it have been to play that body swapping role in Freaky Friday, both on stage and in the DCOM?
Hey, Lawrence, that's so good. D-com. It was the most cool thing ever. I mean, not only was it a huge acting challenge to play the mom and the 16-year-old, and I think I was more appropriately cast for the 16-year-old. But then to not only do that, but then to go from the theatrical version to doing the movie version made my head explode, and I had amazing creative people around me who guided me and helped me make my very first movie.
It was amazing. I know the whole score by heart.
Oh, is that because your kids made you watch that movie over and over and over again?
No, we watched a lot, but it was because my bestie is the star.
You are very sweet, but give me a little room because I got this. Uh-huh. I got this. I can see what you do for me to be you. I got this. I'll make stuff. I can fake like I make stuff like you. I'll have a laugh, have my coffee, have cab, and then on your behalf, I got this.
That is harsh.
Yeah, I got this. I'll put a smile on my face and strut around the place. I got this.
I do not strut.
I'm perfection. I don't need your direction at all. Call me a slob or a slackerish blob. I can act like a snob and fool that mob. I got this. Like it's my job.
I can do that. I got this. Yes, I got this. Do my hair with some hair. I'll prep and prepare. I got this.
You do prep a lot.
I'm delighted.
It's not right. You're excited for school.
Scoff if you may. It's a chronic complaint, and it's only one day. And so I say, I got this. Yes, I got this. I'll be bright and demure, act right till I'm sure they've got this. I'll show you. No, nobody will know. It's not you. Leave it to me, cause how hard could it be when I got my degree and such a spree?
I got this, soon you'll see. I think I'm looking forward to my day to tell the truth.
A day amidst the energy and innocence of youth. A thousand fellow students all excited just like me. A community of learners.
Really?
How hard could it be?
Dear me, I had three slices of a pizza. Are carbs the feeling that I'm feeling? Like I'm losing it, but dealing. It's alarming, but appealing, and somehow healing. Ah! How long has it been since this old heart has skipped a beat? How long have I kept an even key? tough and tough together. No more fear, no more shyness or embarrassment, no diffidence, no doubt, self-consciousness and anxiousness, just throw that stuff right out.
Oh, the flames went on.
I know, Heidi. Where's she gonna come? Who's more powerful, us or the fireworks? Just kidding. We're gonna be done in a second.
But there is one particular song I've always wanted to sing from Frozen.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Okay. And no, seriously, I've sung it many times.
Oh.
But I've always been backstage and alone, so. Would you like to do a little Frozen with me?
I would love to.
Love to?
Yeah.
What do you know about love?
Oh, yeah. Okay.
You got opinions on my life and my relations, but let me tell you what.
Okay, enlighten me.
Love is the one thing that has zero complications, and I can trust my gut.
Okay, you frighten me.
Some people know their hearts the minute true love starts.
Some people read a lot of books.
What? I like books.
Some people simply know.
Taken in by curly locks and princely looks. You know, I think the tall, dark, handsome thing is overrated. All I'm saying is when you go to climb a mountain, nah, you don't just jump to the top.
If it's true love, you can.
Scaling and scrambling, there are too many steps for counting. And the work doesn't stop.
Maybe for you.
Love's not an easy climb. You have to take your time. Love's not a thing you get. It's work and tears and sweat.
So says the sweaty, smelly mountain man. Oh, what do you know I love? What do you know I love? What do you know I love? What do you know I love?
At least we know one thing. Should be interesting.
What do you know I love? What do you know about love?
Thank you so much, Heidi.
So instead of seeing Harmonious, we have decided that we are gonna go on Ratatouille.
You wanna go get in line for Ratatouille? I still love the wallpaper. So cute. Our mousey's coming. Or our rat. Are you excited? Here they come.
He's crawling.
He looks just like Remy.
Do you want to wear the cool glasses? Look. Those are so cool on you.
Be careful, careful.
Oh,
I've got a belly.
Those glasses are so cool on you, Cascan. They're so cool.
Are you ready? Yeah.
Here we go.
Voila, Venez. Suivez-moi, je vous prie.
Very charming.
Chef Remy is waiting for you. This way. Here they are, Remy. Les invités pour le dîner.
Yes, what a dinner. Hein? Pour le repas idéal. Coco vin? Non. A simple omelet? Too simple.
Is that Remy?
What?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oui, that's it.
Whoa.
Hey guys, the food is for them, not you.
Look at that big old fish.
You see the fish? Look at the fish.
Wow, he's so big.
What are you doing? Too many gossip food.
Was that fun? Yeah, you like that, huh?
Did you like that? Was that fun? Go ride on a Vespa? Look at you! Are you on a Vespa? I don't know if this is really a Vespa because it's France and not Italy, but it's a scooter. Are you in a motorcycle? Say vroom vroom! Vroom vroom! Vroom vroom! So we were gonna take the Skyliner, but park is closed now and this is the line for it. And we are not gonna take this. Goodness. It is very long. I think there's like somebody waving a red light way down there, and that's the end of the line for the Skyliner. You can also take a friendship boat, or you can do what we're gonna do, which is walk back to Studios parking lot.
And if a girl that's what, 6 months pregnant can walk it?
Yeah. Let's do it.
All right.
We will tell you how long it takes.
Right now it's 9:40.
The end of the line is at the fork, or the I guess it's the T in the road.
Where you go to the
goodness. Everybody knows how much this boy loves himself a good boardwalk.
It's a good sidewalk,
too. I know, this is a good sidewalk.
Caspian, did you see the water?
Look at the water down there, Caspian. So we said that we need to bring him to the boardwalk at some point just so he can explore and run around, because we know how much he loves the boardwalk, or a boardwalk, so.
Well, this is a nice size sidewalk because we can let him run fairly far ahead.
Yeah, he is quite some ways ahead of us.
Slow down, please.
I said maybe we should do it in March when we are locked out of the park. Although it might be kind of busy because that's during spring break. But
can you wait for us?
We will see. Oh, to have the energy of a toddler.
Caspian, we're not even close to most of the majority of the way. We're still not quite a ways. You're going to get worn out.
That's okay.
Look at the ship. Wow.
Wow, look at that pirate ship.
That's so cool, huh?
Are you on a boardwalk? Yeah, is that so cool? And he's off. We got a little lost and we went over the bridge to the Swan and Dolphin. We're like, this doesn't look right. So we turned back around and went through the boardwalk sign, and now we're back on track. Everything looks different at dark and when you're chasing a toddler around. So
this walk is gonna be a slight bit longer.
It is, yeah. Well, I think it'd be a slight bit longer anyways because I'm pregnant, but we're running to keep up with the toddler anyway, so. We're back on our journey. Just a boy and his Mickey Mouse. Your Mickey Mouse, yeah. And look, and there's
wait to the boat?
A friendship boat.
Wait to the boat. Wait. What do you see over there? What is that? A boat?
A boat.
Yeah.
Look, we're coming up on the Hollywood Studios.
And it is, what time was it? Let's see how long it took. It is 10:11, so it took about a half hour. It
took about a half an hour.
By the time we would have waited for the Skyliner, by the time we would have waited for a boat, it would have been about the same time.
Well, I think even the wait for the Skyliner would have been at least a half an hour, and then the ride on the Skyliner is probably a good 20 minutes between the transfers.
Goes away from Studios.
It does. It goes away before it goes to it because you have to transfer, and the friendship boats stop at every single resort that we walk through. So, I think it's about the same time as what a friendship boat would take.
About that.
And probably shorter than a Skyliner.
We were saying why doesn't more people walk, but we're thinking because a lot of people don't, they forget that there's a walkway the entire way from that.
Yeah.
Because there's a road that you go under, so.
There is. And then we did it because we knew Caspian wouldn't have the patience to wait in the line for the Skyliner, and he was able to burn off some energy with this walk, so.
And wipe out a few times.
He did wipe out a few times running in his sandals, but he is okay.
Now, I will say, there's not a fence the whole way, though. So if you do have young kids, be mindful of that, and you will have to take them by the hand.
Yeah.
Quite a bit of the walk.
Right now, we are walking along sidewalk,
there's gator
grass,
signs.
Gator signs.
The Hollywood Tower Hotel, huh?
Yeah, the Hollywood Tower Hotel.
You want to come tomorrow when it opens, maybe?
Yeah.
Okay, maybe we'll come tomorrow.
Yeah, I think we'll come to Hollywood Studios tomorrow. Tomorrow, though, in the morning, okay?
Yeah, we have to sleep first.
We have to sleep, because it's closed.
It's closed,
yeah.
Very good.
So that concludes our visit out to Disney today.
It took
It took about 40 minutes.
Oh, his knees are very scraped up.
Oh, goodness. It took about 40 minutes to get from Epcot to the parking lot and studios. So,
which isn't bad.
And that's with a 6-month pregnant lady.
Yes. So, not that bad of a walk. Yep. We are going to be back here tomorrow at Hollywood Studios.
We get to see Indy for the first time since it reopened.
We do. It's very exciting.
So.
Sorry, I keep looking down at Caspian. That's so. Okay. Yep. But it was a fun visit. I'm glad we got to see Heidi and Robert. It was the first time seeing Robert because they were very fun. I think it's because they have known each other, and then we saw their last show, so they definitely talked more than what they would normally talk. And ran over, so but it was fun. So we have two more pairs to see for the Disney on Broadway concert series, and those are the ones that are coming up in the next couple weeks. And then they have the four at like the last day, so we'll definitely be here for that too. So there's more Festival of the Arts one vlogs coming up, and I definitely want to come and actually do more of the Festival of the Arts stuff, like make a full day of it rather than just coming at night, because we've just been coming at night because we've been able to. But as always, guys, thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.